الحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد و praise Allah سبحانه وتعالى abundantly and ask Allah to exalt the mention and send peace upon the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. If you're watching this in Ramadan, then in the year 2016 or 1437, then you agree with me that we only have a few days left. And people talk about Laylatul Qadr, the virtues of Laylatul Qadr, and that is a topic of its own. But how do we really maximize the benefit in these nights? There are multiple ways. Each Allah Azza wa Jalla facilitates for each person what is their point of strength at times. And there are some things that are very easy for all of us, some things that are difficult to achieve. But among the easy things that any one of us should be able to do is going early to the masjid. And this is like such a huge opportunity and potential for abundance of good deeds that somehow we miss out on the whole Ramadan, specifically the last 10 nights. And the subject matter is simple. Once you break your fast, hopefully with a light meal, you have that time between Maghrib and Isha, which is usually spent either eating or socializing or updating your Facebook with the pictures of the food you just ate. What is better than all of that, however, is to head out to the masjid that early. Go out to the masjid. Now, we know there are many virtues for going to the masjid early. These are the houses of worship which Allah Azza wa Jal, destined to be established on earth. And he mentioned that in there are men who remember Allah and are not distracted by trade or anything of the sort that distracts them from the Iqam al-Salah wa Ita al-Zakah and so on and so forth. Secondly, we have the hadith of the Prophet ﷺ that the angels will continue to make dua for the person while he is waiting for the salah. Allahumma ighfir lahu, Allahumma arhamhu. Further, he is in the state of salah as long as he is waiting for the salah, according to another hadith from the Prophet ﷺ. So imagine from the time you enter the masjid, let's say you stay there for an hour before Adhan al-Isha. This whole time, even though you might be sitting, relaxing, or reading some Quran, or talking to maybe your family on the phone, hopefully not distracting the people in the masjid, you might even be occupied with other things, which is not recommended, but even if so, that whole time, you're given the ajr of someone engaged in salah. Imagine if you were actually also engaged in salah. So that's now double the reward, simply for being there early. Then you get to catch the first row. Then you get to focus with the imam. You're less distracted than someone who came late or after the adhan. Then of course you'll be praying in the fourth, fifth, sixth row where it stinks and people squeeze themselves. And this is, the whole environment is completely different. Between the first row and the seventh row is like between the heavens and the earth sometimes in your local masjid. So all this potential reward. And you know, this is a time for you to make dua. You know, the dua al-ma'thur for Laylatul Qadr. Allahumma naka afuun tuhibbu al-afwa fa'afu anni. This is all happening maybe in that 1 hour, 1 hour and a half, which is a time that is often wasted on nothingness. So my reminder for myself, first and foremost, and for you, my brothers and sisters, actually, even for the sisters, is try to utilize this time and go early to the masjid so you can be better prepared for Salatul Isha and for the Taraweeh. We ask Allah Azza wa Jal to make that easy for all of us. هذا والله أعلم وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد.